reflection of light with plane mirrors. So the plan for today is reflection of light demonstrations. In the demonstrations, I want to show you how light reflects in plane mirror. Also spherical mirrors. Okay, spherical mirror, we have convex and concave. So now you just need to see what happens, then we will learn the theory of that. Now I need to switch off these two fans directly because the object which is going to emit light is going to be a candle.
Candles.
Why don't you just get a torch?
Whoa.
Because I need a point object. Please be quiet and please watch. Let's not waste time. I have a lot of demonstrations to do, okay? Close the door. You can come near the, stand near the wall. You stand near the wall. You don't need to note down anything, just note it in your mind, watch how many I can do. I think we need to switch off the fans here. I can't explain why it's kicking so much. Now I'll make it low. Because the frame was really low. Okay, now we have a good. So now this is called a real object. Rather, this is called a real object because it's emitting light rays in all directions. And before these light rays hit any optical element, by optical element I mean any device which will bend the light's path. For example, it could be a plane mirror, it could be a concave mirror, convex mirror, any lens, they are all called optical elements. So the rays from the object will first hit the optical element and then something will happen. Light is going to hit the optical element, that is called incidence. So when a light is falling on this optical element, we call it as incident. So before the light is incident, what rays are present? Incident rays. After the light is incident, if it is reflected, it will be reflected rays. If it is lens, it will be called refracted rays. So we use the term before incidence and after incidence. So before incidence, what is present? Is image present before incidence? Only object will be present. And after incidence, what will be created?
Image
will be created. Clear or not?
Yes, sir.
So incident rays will represent object. And after incidence, if you have reflected ray, it will represent image. Refracted ray will also represent image. Clear till now?
Yes, sir. Said not to switch off the
fan. No fans, please. No.
It was off.
Okay, R.A. Prakash, please.
Prakash,
be quiet. Stop fighting. We are on camera, please. Okay. So now, this plane mirror, let us see what it does. Right now, you know that a plane mirror forms what type of image?
Reflection.
What type of image?
Reflection.
Real image or virtual image?
Virtual.
Can a plane mirror form a real image?
No.
No?
Concave.
Okay. So, all of you are thinking it cannot, right? What is the main difference between a real image and a virtual image?
The real image is formed in front of the...
The real image is...
One second, Kathya.
The real image is formed in front of the mirror and the virtual image is formed behind the...
So one key difference is real image is formed in a place where I can place a screen and capture it. Agreed?
Yes.
But virtual image cannot be captured on a screen because it is a virtual thing. There are no actual light rays intersecting at that point. Agreed?
Yes.
So if I see my face in the mirror, it forms a virtual image. I cannot get the image on a screen if I keep it behind the mirror. Agreed?
Sir,
let me repeat what I said.
Sir, if you take a picture of the phone, it's a real image.
It's not about taking a picture with your phone. With a phone acts like a camera, acts like your eye. So a phone can capture virtual image as well as real image. What I mean is placing a screen. For example, this is a screen. If I have a plain mirror here, if I look into the mirror, I can see my face behind the mirror. Agree? But if I keep the screen behind the mirror, can I see my face on the screen?
No.
No. So virtual image cannot be captured on the screen, only real image can be captured on the screen. Can you see your face? Can you see it? What can you see?
I can see.
Okay, you can see something, right? That something which you see is definitely behind the mirror. So if I keep a screen behind the mirror, can that something appear on the mirror, on the screen? Can it appear? It won't, right? So that image which you see is created in your brain. It's a virtual image. It cannot be captured on a screen. Okay? So all of you think that a plain mirror can only form virtual image. But now I am going to show to you that a plain mirror can also form a real image.
Real?
Yes. So let us see how to do that. And once you see how I do it, you have to come up with the explanation of what is happening. Understood? What is your task? You have to use your brain and come up with an explanation of how a plain mirror is creating a real image. I have not taught you that. You have to see and think and figure it out. Okay? Okay, so I will explain as I go along. This is a convex lens. A convex lens is a lens which is thick in the middle. Thicker in the middle, thinner at the edges. Basically a fat person is convex. 10%, this is a lens, it's transparent. So it's a convex lens, I will keep it in this stand. Now I need to adjust the height.
Spoiled.
Are they the same height?
Yes,
a plane, a stone behaves like a spherical mirror.
So,
the shiny surface of the stone, depending on the convex side or concave side, it will behave like a convex or concave mirror. Right now, this is an image formed by a lens. Okay? So, I bring it closer than that, it gets blurred, out of focus. If you take it away from that point also, it gets blurred, out of focus. So, there is only one point where you get a sharp image, which I call as the location of the image, so image position.
What if we take it closer?
So the point, that's what I showed you just now, it got blurred, right?
So can we say from the location?
So can we say that the
that is literally
like the distance from the candle to that mirror?
That is called object distance. Candle is the object. This is the lens.
So then distance the distance between, will be same.
No, there is no rule like that.
Like for the exact.
How the distance will be there? There is a formula. It's called Lenz formula, mirror formula. I will teach all that later on.
One sec, sir. But for example, if the distance from the candle to the mirror is like let's say 10 centimeters, and if we put exactly 10 centimeters distance from the mirror to that screen, will we get the location?
No. It can be anything. You have a formula to predict the distance, I'm saying. It depends on the object distance. If you change the object distance, image distance will change. See, for example.
So I thought that the
listen. See now. We bring it closer, it got out of focus. Right? We bring it even closer. Again, it became out of focus. Come this side. From there, how can you see? So now you see. Again, it became out. Now here it is in focus. If I take it away,
bigger.
If I take it away, it became out of focus. So now see where it came out, in focus. So this place.
So it becomes bigger as you take it closer to the...
Are you getting it?
Yeah.
So depending on the object distance, image distance will change. All those who are sleeping, please stand. Get sit up, sit straight.
Sir, image distance...
Sir, because the rays spread out.
Image distance.
Every class you are sleeping, Jinai, it's a permanent
observation. Like this. And when it moves out, it spreads out like this.
Okay. So now you remember my original goal? My goal is to create a real image by a plate mirror. So now see what I do. I will take this plate mirror. Wait, just to adjust the height. Now by keeping the plane mirror here, in between the lens and the screen, I have blocked the light rays which are going to form the real image. Now listen carefully to what I am saying. The light rays which were going to form the image on the screen, Vivan,
will reflect.
Sit up straight. The light rays which were converging and meeting at the screen to form the real image of the candle, those light rays are now incident on the plane mirror. Agreed? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
But so now those rays actually represent a virtual object now. So now if I put the screen here, how do I keep it here? Wait. I need something to create the height.
Right here.
Now you have to bring the camera this side.
Sir?
You have to come this side.
Magic water and come. Camera magic water.
Kya bol raha hai? It is creating a real image on the screen here. If you stand behind the screen, how can you see?
So that way, if you remove the lens, then also it will form a real image.
How it will form? It won't. In order to create this real image, I had to create a virtual object. Okay, now go to your place, I will explain.
So what is the
use of this in real life?
Use of this in real life is that you are understanding what is a virtual object, what is a real object, what is a virtual image, what is a real image.
So imagine what I
saw. Okay, go to your place. Okay, go to your place.
So imagine what I saw.
Okay. Okay, I want all of you to go to your place. This is to...
So imagine what I saw.
Go to your place, let me explain. I hope you paused it.